open things up with Lenny Lane against Marty Jannetty. And Marty Jannetty, the 14-year pro, Scott, is another veteran wrestler that's taking full advantage of WCW's open door policy. Much like a Barry Darso, a John Nord, or a Chris Adams, Marty Jannetty wants to test his skill level against the top competition to see if he can compete with the big boys of WCW. And we open things up with Jannetty and Lenny Lane.
The wrestling world still buzzing about last Sunday night in Mobile, Alabama at Uncensored, and also what went down Monday in Panama City Beach involving Sting. We'll have much more about that later. That may be the most incredible piece of footage I've ever seen involved in pro wrestling. If you did not see it, stay with us. We'll take another look at what happened at Club La Vila last Monday night on Nitro.
Hands down, the most dramatic ring entrance in the history of professional wrestling. And to compound matters, Eric Bischoff and the NWO, they were cocky and confident that Sting was nowhere to be seen in Panama City. What an entrance he made, and wow, did he prove the New World Order wrong.
We will see that entrance later on Saturday night. Also, we'll go back to Terre Haute, Indiana, and WCW Thunder and Bill Goldberg. Unbelievable Goldberg making his presence felt to the New World Order.
And wow, did the NWO bail out when Goldberg hit the ring Thursday on Thunder.
Much more about Nitro, Thunder, and of course, Spring Stampede coming up April 19th on pay-per-view. We've got news about that big event still to come. Right now, Lenny Lane and Marty Jannetty are going to start us off, and every time I see Lenny Lane, I'm just disgusted. We remember the ruse he and Chris Jericho pulled on Dean Malenko a couple of weeks ago. Malenko thought he was wrestling Chris Jericho wearing a Juventud Guerrero mask. Got the win. I was going to say pinned him. Made him submit to the Texas Cloverleaf. He ripped the mask off, and it's Lenny Lane. This guy, I have no use for Lenny Lane anymore.
Well, Lenny Lane obviously was an accomplice of Chris Jericho, the WCW World's Cruiserweight Champ. Lenny Lane, he was dressed entirely in Jericho's ring attire to play mind games with Dean Malenko. Well, Chris Jericho's partner in crime, Lenny Lane, or is he? Because Lenny Lane feels that he also was duped, Scott.
He was.
Part of a setup is how he worded it when I spoke with Lenny Lane. According to Lenny Lane, he plans to be at Nitro this Monday at Freedom Hall in Louisville, Kentucky, to confront Chris Jericho. And we also remember that Mr. Jericho attacked both Dean Malenko and Lenny Lane after that charade. I can't wait to hear Lenny Lane's side of the story and Jericho's response as well.
That's coming up Monday night on Nitro. Like, that show couldn't get any hotter. But with the return of Rowdy Roddy Piper, much more about Roddy Piper tonight on Saturday night. Marty Jannetty really having it handed to him by Lenny Lane here. Jannetty, a very accomplished tag team wrestler. We all know about that. But I don't know, as a single, he's having a hard time with Lenny. Lenny's been impressive.
Certainly has. Lenny Lane has been very competitive in matchups across the board with many of the top cruiserweights here in World Championship Wrestling. And he's certainly taking it to Marty Jannetty in the early going. Leg drop with authority. Here's the cover.
Little slow on the cover. Did hook the leg, but only got the two count from Charles Robinson. And Lenny Lane, this, you know, it was one thing to look like Chris Jericho, but he's acting like Chris Jericho. He's got that attitude going in there. That's disappointing.
Well, it's going to be interesting to see what he has to say Monday at Nitro about he and Jericho and the plan that they really used to mess with the mind of Dean Malenko prior to their battle at Uncensored.
And we know that Dean Malenko has now told us he's going home. I mean, he may be giving it up. He's going to pack it all in and head back home to Tampa.
Sure sounded that way. Just a one-word response. His answer to Gene Okerlund.
Cover. Two count by Lenny Lane.
Okerlund asked him where he was going. He simply said home. How do you translate something like that?
I don't know. There's not many ways that you can say go home and have it not mean that you're going home. Sunset flip now by Marty Jannetty. Lenny Lane fights his way out. Gets the knees down. The cover. Jannetty rolls him up. Cradle. And he got the two count on Lenny Lane.
Nonchalant cover by Lenny Lane in the schoolboy press. Easily reversed by Jannetty. Now catapults him into the corner.
Right into the turnbuckle, and Jannetty rolls him back up. The two. Oh, and he got the two count. That was so close. Oh, man.
Lane turned him inside out with that short clothesline.
Into a 360 by Marty Jannetty, and Lenny Lane out of nowhere with the lariat. Lenny sets him up, going to shoot him into the turnbuckle. Lenny Lane waits on him, goes for the bulldog, no go, Marty Jannetty.
There it is. He calls that move the showstopper.
The showstopper from Marty Jannetty. And the three count, and just like that, Marty Jannetty starts us off with the victory on WCW Saturday Night. Fans, big tag team main event still to come with Raven and Saturn. Stay with us.